Come and consume. to adore you. Oh, we love you. We love you. And we'll never stop. We can't live without you. Jesus, we love you. And we can't get enough. All this is for you. Jesus.
As part of this sweet worship, I sing in, we can't live without you, Jesus. We have a group of people that we are going to celebrate with this morning as part of our worship. They're going to come into the waters of baptism. When we give our lives to Jesus, there's two baptisms that happen. We give our hearts to him, he enters our lives, and man is made right before God. And then the Bible describes two baptisms. There's a baptism of water and a baptism of the Spirit. The baptism of water is what's happening today. It's not a change in their relationship with God. It's not for them to get closer to God. What this is a public declaration to say to the world, I have decided that he is my Lord and Savior. And so I'm going to invite you guys up onto the stage. We've got our team coming to baptize the guys this morning. And I want to encourage you, feel free, church, just to come forward, come to the front of the stage, and just cheer them on, be praying for them this morning. In the tank, they're going to be asked, do you confess Jesus as your Lord and Savior? And their answer is going to be yes. And we're going to, it's our joy to baptize them this morning. So we're going to carry on with worship. If anyone is here today and you really want to be baptized, I want you just to come and see us at the side of the stage, and we can chat to you there. But let's just carry on in an environment of worship as these people make their public confessions today.
Thank you.
glorious King, for the shining King. Yeah.
opportunity for bravery right now. We kind of did it in first service, but I'm just really feeling that again. Like, there's something about getting outside of our norm, getting outside of the routine of what we normally do in worship. We love your presence, Lord. In your presence, we come alive. We come alive. Every part of our spirit comes alive. Every part of our heart comes alive. Every part of our body comes alive. So if you would, if you feel comfortable, let's just partner with that. Dancing is not something I normally do in worship because it can get a little awkward. But that's good, right? Sometimes we need to get uncomfortable in worship in order to get there, you know? He's so faithful to meet you there. He's so faithful to meet you there. Okay, let's sing it again. Awake my soul.
We'll be right back.
is the